What the fuck's happening, people? Welcome to this week's episode of General Banter Podcast that is hosted by me, Colin Geddis, and my guest today is my wife again.
Yeah.
Máirín.
Hello.
Is back. I'm not going to say any more dates. I always say the date at the top of these, then they never go out on that day. And then Niall dates it the day that it's done, and then I put it up with a different name for the day that I put it up. And I'm all over the place, Máirín.
Yeah, no one cares about dates anymore anyway, so...
No, time isn't real, not in this day and age.
No.
So that's a quote, isn't it? Time isn't real in this day and age. Darkness.
Wow.
Let's get right into it with our sponsors, shall we?
Yeah.
Today our sponsors, as usual, are manscaped.com. Of course, this is like one of these sponsorship deals where they pay and I talk about it. And this is what's happening.
Okay.
Valentine's Day is coming up. They've got lots of packages. They've got the tools for your family jewels, Máirín. You know what I'm saying?
Excellent.
If you own pubes, this is the product for you.
Get you, it? Yeah, you must buy this.
You must buy this. And it's called Manscaped, but it might as well be... That's because they can't call it Pubescaped. It just won't sell. So anyone can buy this, really. It used to be directed at men, but, you know, it's anti-snag, which means it's designed so that it won't trap your ball skin. Which is Rumpelstiltskin, the remix, Trap Your Ballskin. And I dare say it would leave your flaps unscathed also. So it's the product for you. A little more 3.0, they've got another thing called a weed whacker, which is like a circular razor, which goes in pretty much any circular hole you can dream up.
Or for any non-binary business you've got going on down there.
Whatever fucking trans exit hole you've got, you can shove this in and just
around it.
And you know, depending on how hairy you are, I don't know how often you need to do that. Get it around there, get rid of it. Got all sorts of products here, ball deodorant, because dudes be walking around there with some stinking ball bags.
Saves a shower, like, didn't it?
It saves a shower. Yes, it's a lockdown. Showers are rare and expensive. Just put a bit of ball deodorant around there and act like you've washed. Okay. They've got a ball toner, which is proven scientifically to remove all wrinkles from your nuts. So you will come out with two perfectly squeaky spherical nuts, which is actually creepy. Isn't it?
Yeah, you don't really want that.
You don't want total.
Don't use too much.
You know, like, girls always like, eh, dude's balls are gross and wrinkly. Imagine you pull one out and it was like taut as fuck. Squeaky. Like, actually, like an egg. Like a real egg. Anyway.
Going off topic.
We're going off topic. They're launching a cologne, which is American, African-American for aftershave. And it smells great. It smells like you've just had a shower. Once again, avoiding the shower, most importantly.
Yeah.
Listeners of this podcast can
Don't wash your hair either. Just shave it off.
Nah, yeah, fuck it. Just go full Auschwitz with it. We're losing the sponsor. Oh, across the head. Up the beard, down the ball bag. You come out just looking like fucking E.T.
Yeah. Put your smells on, ready to go.
Yeah.
Nowhere.
Cool. Yeah, if you listen to this podcast and use the code GenBant1, you get 20% off your purchases. Taking away the pubes also adds 20% onto the shaft, like we say very often around here.
Yeah.
Okay. And we'll be back later with our second sponsor, Flow CBD. Let's play the intro, shall we?
Yeah.
Podcast with Colin Geddis. Short and sweet. There we go.
I like it.
So you're back on the podcast today, Máirín.
Yeah, this was not meant to happen, but here I am.
It's the slow takeover. What happened was you did a podcast last week. I was going to put it on Patreon. I thought you said some very valuable things that some people needed to hear.
Oh, thank you.
And I exploited the fact that you were on the podcast and that we might get more viewers.
Okay.
Because people love a bit of drama, you know, 10 years in comedy, doing all sorts of major achievements. But as soon as your wife gets sick, bro, they're all over you.
Yeah.
Do you want to do the radio? Do you want a radio show? Do you want a book deal? People are all over you once you get a bit of sickness.
I know.
Which is just this country. It's fucked.
Love a bit of misery, don't they?
Right? Nothing exciting about you, you know, trailblazing in comedy in a humorless fucking shit pit like this place.
I know, you can imagine how much sympathy I get at home whenever you're jealous of my attention.
Oh, fucking hell, my career can do a bit of illness. I'm joking, I wouldn't wish it on my worst spouse. oh No, what happened was you were on, and then I released that to the public, and people were like, great stuff. Get her back on. I said, never. And then just by chance today, you had to drop you to the hospital. You thought you were going to be ages. And then you were like, no, there's fuck all wrong with me. So I had to go get you and bring you a bit down here.
Yeah, I thought I needed some blood today. Turned out I didn't, which is good.
So here we are. Yeah, so they took that well-harvested blood and they just poured it in the street. I seen them. They just walked out in the car park in Craigavon, poured it over
someone's
car.
I have it home with me, though, if I need it.
You what?
I have it home with me.
The blood, yeah. They're like, listen, we have to throw this in the bin. Have you any use for this blood?
Take away cup.
And you're like, I'm doing a roast later. Yeah.
But this is also why I look so rough right now.
You look great, Maureen.
But I was just saying before recorded here, I actually got messages about from people saying that they liked my makeup, which I actually quite like. People are like, this isn't an important message, but what were you? And I'm like, I love this. Ask me about makeup. I love it. But now,
I got those questions every week.
To prove the power of makeup, here I am, not realizing I was going anywhere other than hospital, looking.
We were doing a bit of slobbering earlier about people. Did you say that they were bringing in these laws or something where it's like if you're promoting a skincare product, you can't have a filter?
Yeah, if you're doing like some sort of Instagram promotion to do with like a product, you can't have a beauty filter on, which I have seen a lot of people doing.
Yeah, you can't be there and be like, buy this
laughable.
Face. Buy like, this face cream
I'm gonna
and it's, you got dog ears on.
They're doing like an Instagram story of like them doing their makeup. I'm going to show you how to do makeup or I'm showing you what I use my skin. And it's like the filter at the top is like, you know, beautiful face filter. Yeah. And I tried one of them one day, some girl was using from here. And I pressed on it and obviously my face looks like this. And I was like, oh my God. Because obviously I don't really have any eyebrows or eyelashes left right now. So I could actually tell the difference. And it was literally like my lips were twice as big. Full eyebrows on, like literally all the eyelashes, everything, your skin perfect. Changed the shape of my face slightly.
And she's like, this tube of shit for £80
going to fix it. Putting on makeup and it's like full. And like they look absolutely fine. Like they're like, it's not like they needed the filter. And I was like, how can you do this and then be putting on makeup as if you're showing people how to use it or, you know, showing off product? You're not even seeing it. It's not like, even your face.
It's like when people were going like, you know, we sell this program. It's called the 300 workout. And you can have a body like one of the guys on 300. And then Jared Butler was like, oh, it's just a fucking bunch of CGI, man.
Yeah, it's an honestly
fake six pack.
So there you go. No makeup on today.
You look great, Maury. In a sort of Ice Queen kind of Disney. No, I'm joking.
Do you know what? Actually, though, I do feel like I need makeup these days because I need it for like, my eyebrows aren't that bad. They haven't totally gone this time, which is good. But like, I do feel like my face does look like a bit like an egg right now because I have no.
Welcome to my world.
But you have a beard. And
I wish I had a beard. Shout out to William from Flow CBD was in giving us trinkets a minute ago. That guy has a beard.
He does have a beard.
It's all he has.
Lots of hair. He's lots of hair.
Well, who was the guy who actually really cut his hair or his beard or something and he died?
What?
That's a biblical story.
Oh, I didn't know what you were talking about.
Now you know the Bible. Who got his hair cut and lost all his powers?
Gandalf?
Samson?
Is that not the Korean?
Yeah. Korean?
You probably can't hear now because he doesn't have a mic, even though it's been requested several times. He sold it. He's selling all the gear.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here, actually, Maureen, because I've nothing really to talk about. Because it's lockdown 3.0 and nothing happens. Nothing happens. We did a Zoom fucking quiz or something on Friday. What was that?
Taskmaster?
I had depression on Friday because I sat in a car all day and I was, first time ever, 34 years old. I was like, I need to drink today just to feel something.
I know.
Fuck.
Well, you've gone a long way through lockdowns to only feel that now.
Yeah, most people, Mickey. 2 weeks before lockdown, he was feeling it.
Mickey's been drinking since before lockdown.
But honestly, like, I love, you know, I'm Frank the Tank. I'm like, I'm okay. And then I'm like, you feel it as soon as it hits your lips. And then I can drink loads. Mm-hmm. But I'm happy enough to, like, not. But then on Friday, I was like, I'm drinking because I need to not feel whatever this is.
Oh, tell us how you feel.
And then we did, it was a Taskmaster via Zoom. Which was very funny.
It was funny.
Zoom can't keep up with the big man. I feel like writing a note to Zoom.
Well, because
Zoom, the amount of fucking grade A banter lost to fucking lag. Fuck you. I'm out there.
I know.
The amount of things I said and no one responded. And then you went, Colin 30 seconds ago said this. And then everyone's rolling off the seats and all. And I was like, fuck's sake, keep up, Zoom. useless.
Yeah, there's definitely a fault because it only sort of picks up the loudest voice kind of thing. So if someone's talking, even if you could say something and no one else can hear it, it's annoying.
Man.
But yeah.
No room for, what's the word, nuance? Is that a word? Am I saying that right?
Yeah.
I should have read some books over lockdown.
Yeah.
To be honest. An other crack?
No, my life's right now just monitoring blood.
Blood watch?
Yeah.
Welcome back to Blood Watch with Maureen.
It's about as exciting as it gets, but like, how many neutrophils do I have today?
I don't know whether you're I don't know whether you're talking about the stock market or your blood sometimes. You come in and I'm like, I'm up 2.3 on the thing and down 3.3 and
that's what it's
up
like.
To 7%. If I get to 70% by the end of the week, fuck me, I can just fucking slip my guts up and let them fall out of that much blood. Harry Carey.
Yeah. Yeah. It's it's honestly about as exciting as this is getting right now.
But you have to be careful what you eat and stuff, don't you? But what confuses me is the way you pick and choose them.
What?
Because you're like, I'll not get a Five Guys, but I'll get a lead out of another place. And I'm like, what's the difference?
It just because of the type of food that I'm eating. I don't worry, like, when you're neutropenic, which means you've, I know, you've, your neutrophils are under one, which means you've less, you're less able to fight normal infection, like, that you would get from food.
Yeah.
That wouldn't bother someone else. So just the idea of a burger, I was like, I don't want meat to cook somewhere. I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't have anything like that. Whereas this was like chips. So can't go wrong. How wrong can you go with chips?
You played it safe with a black pudding bap.
No.
Blood in that also. Would you drink raw blood? You know, if you were doing one of those, if you were doing one of those like travel shows and you were somewhere and no. They're like, what we do is we take the heart out and it's still fucking going like this.
No.
And then you just pour it right out.
Well, I don't think I ever would have done it, but I definitely think I wouldn't be able to now after having a stem cell transplant. I can't even have regular blood transfusions. I have to have irradiated blood, sure. Where they take out the white cells because I've had a stem cell transplant. My body might try and
attack your own blood.
Take the cells and think it's and another transplant and then it boom, you can have like...
Explode.
You can sort of have like, I don't know, you can take reactions and stuff. So I actually have to have like special blood. So I think drinking the blood of another animal is kind of out of the question now.
Fucking pussy.
I know, shame. That was the only thing I also had on my bucket list really. Was drink more.
Drink blood, drink blood. Get more.
Yeah. You know when people do those like craft beer tours? I was trying to see how many types of blood I could have.
Wow.
Yeah, that's just can't happen now. It's unfortunate.
It's like Twilight.
I know. But yeah.
Do you ever remember that show that came up and it was about like, these are real life vampires?
And oh yeah.
We were talking about Marilyn Manson last time. These were two fat dad goths and they were just like, you know, like the most, can I try and find it?
Oh, yeah. That's a good
Is that
sign.
A problem? My new gilet all over the microphone? Guys, I got a gilet. I'm really feeling myself. And by feeling myself, I mean sweating down my butt crack.
Quite like it.
I like it too. It's very big and puffy, like, but I'm a big guy.
Mm.
You know? I can't be wearing a tight one. So let me just, you don't need to go to the screen just yet because there is porn. There is porn, and I don't want you to see that. Let me see. Real life vampires. These two were the most boring bastards. And they were like, sometimes when we can't get, like... Meet a vampire couple from England. I'm in! We need to see these
it's
two.
It's such made up horseshit, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, but they're like, when we can't find any victims or whatever.
We really need the blood. You're like, no, you don't.
There are self-described vampires still living in the world today, and they're not rampaging through the country.
What's funny is, you know, we're like crazy and we feed on the thing, but then we also, well, they're not American. We also spend a lot of time putting safety pins in my liver duster.
Mountains in Eastern Europe. They live in Slough to the west of Europe, and their names, Arrow.
Look at that guy. Oh, fuck.
Raven and Leah Benninghoff.
What's his name? Al the Raven?
There's vampires everywhere. Vampires can be doctors, nurses, solicitors, bank managers, mechanics, someone working in a local supermarket, your friends, your family, We could be anyone.
There's a lot of extra effort gone into, like, I have to work. I work normally as a butcher, and then I have to go to the MAC counter to get some black lipstick. Do you reckon his teeth are that bad? He just was like, I'll pretend I'm a vampire.
Yeah, that's how it starts, yeah.
I'll pretend I'm a vampire, work back.
When I first saw that he was a vampire, it was very interesting. I was like, okay, didn't know there was actually proper real vampires out there.
Because there's not.
I always hoped there was. And to finally meet one was actually very interesting, to finally get to know what it really is and everything.
Contemporary vampire. Jesus Christ.
What the lifestyle's like and everything like that.
But it's not real.
That whole erotic sense of vampirism and drinking each other's blood, that kind of...
She looks like a vampire. Look at them teeth, man. It,
but really, there's no benefit from it.
She fully looks like a vampire. Why did not she's say...
Yeah, she's hiding plain sight there.
Why did not say fucking contemporary vampire under her name? Said author.
I would believe more that they're actual vampires if they looked normal.
She's all fucking teeth and like, these guys are kind. You know, she's definitely a fucking... Look at her face, man.
Basically go through your body and then it's...
Bro. Look at her face. The other two are just two fat goth dads. She's literally like muscular neck from hanging from the roof like a bat.
Intimate connection to it. But really, there's no benefit from it. It basically goes through your body and then it's expelled. There's no actual health benefit to it. And actually, it could be dangerous if you're taking high levels of blood into your system.
She's just drinking that like she's having a Malbec.
It would not taste good.
As you could overdose on iron. But in terms of blood transfusions, that's...
Hey, full vampire. Different. I mean, she's a werewolf. She's really holding back the werewolf.
At any second, I'm about to burst out of my skin. Honestly.
That's a necessary medical...
Normal. Many teeth do humans have? Like 32? 36? Yeah. Many teeth is it? Count them. She's like, I have 9 rows of teeth like a shark.
Procedure, there is a benefit to that, but that's a completely separate issue than drinking blood.
Leah says that she can remember the exact moment that Arrow turned her into a...
This could be us, Maureen. But you playing?
Empire. And she drank human blood.
I mean, it looks like she just fell off her skateboard there. It doesn't look like they're opening veins for blood at all.
The first time.
Stop it. That's a lot. That's quite a lot of blood.
There's no sides at all. Two sirloins and 2 glasses away. Would it kill you to put it on like a piece?
Ever heard of wedges?
I was like, do you want normal wedges or spicy? I was like, I can't do spicy. Do you know what?
I'll take a tummy.
Yeah, I have to work more. I'll take a blood shandy. Put a wee bit of soda in mine.
Yeah, like the one that's fizzy.
Yeah, that's half flat.
That's got flat.
You can tell the guys. He's like, lovely. We're vampires. He's like, look at his face. He's like,
It had to be at night at 3 a.m. in the morning. The witching hour.
I bet you how many takes did they do that? Take a sip, turn around like you're not gonna fucking barf everywhere.
And really, it all consisted of he drank my blood and then I drank his blood.
Man, one more time just to clear that up.
I drank his blood.
Wow.
Like a sort of a cycle feed.
The vampire culture has people we class as donors, who are people who willingly allow us to feed from them. So, like I said, there are some, I'm sure, out there who...
This is what you have in mind, you know what I mean? Like the slutty vampire? Not these two dorks.
Would try and take it by force, but... Most of us believe in, you know, respecting other people's wishes, other people's bodies. We don't do anything to harm others or, you know, even for whether it's for our own benefit or anything else.
Well, me oh, too.
Nice to know.
Me too, making its way into the vampire world. Great. I wouldn't want to be forcing myself for somebody else's neck.
a lot to ask for.
But like, surely they know it's like they know it's they've made it up. You know what I mean?
Of
like,
course. Yeah.
They know that they have just decided to do this.
Yeah.
I just.
The two of them are fucking lunatics. Do you know? It's better that they eat, like, you know, raw meat from a butcher's instead of children the way they'd like to, probably.
I mean.
But it's just the, it's the dorkness. It's the dorkiness of it I don't like.
I don't care about dorkiness. To me, it's just like, they're adults.
Can you help me with my mascara?
But do you mean, like, that's a man who probably has a job somewhere?
Oh, yeah. These people, postman?
Yeah, but it's usually just something regular. And then they're all.
What job would he do that you would just shut the door behind you and leave?
And leave? Like, he has something and I'll go to.
What if you're going to, like, talk about the man, a guy about a mortgage advisor? You just open the door, he's like, come in. He's hanging from the roof. Come in.
Big long nails on a desk like this.
Or what if he's just a, delivery guy walking up with a wee scanner? Did you order something?
Gloop. That's what they do look like.
Gives you your package and he's just got fucking, you know, throws a cape around and wee bit of smoke. He's back in the van.
And then you just see him run into the van.
And it won't start. It's in reverse. Oh.
But he puts his cape out the window.
Yeah. Stands on it and trips before he gets to the car. And she doesn't do that job, but she just goes with him all day.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
And, like, they're just sitting there, like, you know, do you want to get some blood? And he's like, I feel more like a Pizza Hut today. Do you want the Domino's? Yeah. Get me extra tomato sauce. I'm a vampire. Just knackered. Anemic. Oh, my. So, once again, another good argument for donating blood, isn't that right? Give blood, save lives.
For vampires. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. My eye's twitching like mad. Why is that? Tiredness?
Oh, don't touch it. Don't touch it.
Okay. I've got another. How long have we been talking for? That feels like enough. Is that enough?
We've covered all the important points today.
23 minutes. Which brings us nicely along to throat babies. I was.
Does it?
Yeah, it's been a weird week. I saw someone share a thing and they were like, these are the dangers of TikTok.
It's been a weird week. It's Monday.
Yeah.
I mean, we're not saying what day it is.
Time is an illusion.
I know. What? When does a week start or end, really?
I don't know.
It depends on how you
work it. I'm a guy with 30,000 watches and I'm like, I have no time. I bet if I took all the watches off, I'd be like, man, chill, eh? Full day. Anyway, someone shared this thing and they were talking about apparently the world of TikTok is ruining teenagers' lives. Teenagers are assholes. They always find a way to bully each other to death, no matter what format it's on, multi-platform, multimedia bullying. They always find a way. And TikTok, you know, they're really body shaming people.
I actually did see that video you were talking about.
Yeah, well, there was this
scary.
There was this thing where, like, you know, like a girl would put like iPhone headphones, the wired ones, round her waist twice, and then tie it, and then be like this, and that was a new challenge. And obviously, if you're not like a malnourished fucking 7-stone Chinese girl, you can't really do that. And people are going, oh man, I need to be fucking anorexic now because I can't time it. First of all, get AirPods. That solves all the problems.
That would solve everything, but, yeah.
Yeah, people are worried about that. There was a video where there was, once again, very Asian, this stuff. You know, he would go up to a girl and he would take off his face covering and stretch it around her waist and see if it fitted. And then he went and stretched it around the other girl's waist and it broke and he took the skinny girl by the hand. And it's teaching these young children to have eating disorders. But I don't really see the problem because now in this day and age, if you don't want to be skinny, you can always just be brave and fat. I'm joking, I said that just to be a cunt. But yeah, it's a...
Oh, it's one extreme to the other, isn't it?
It really is. It really is. Where's the nice middle class of, you know, what, just kind of stay in shape if you want to?
Just regular vampires?
Yeah. These guys, keto? It's keto?
Yeah, basically.
They're keto vampires? But yeah, there was a whole load of stuff like that. Dudes being like massively overly sexual. And obviously, you know, to a teenage girl, this guy's like a hot dude. And they're like, oh my God, is that what I need to do to please dudes now? You know?
Terrifying.
Let them choke me and fucking piss in my mouth. Oh.
He looked like a real wee dick as well, didn't he?
Just a wee fuck boy. He's like, man, I was choking this girl. And I said, open your mouth and a spat in her mouth. Bro, this is all bells and whistles. We're here to squirt, all right? I don't need to, you don't need to fucking... act like you're a porn star. There's no one watching you. get to the squirt and mage. You don't be choking people, spit in your mouth. Extracurricular.
Who wants to be spat in their mouth? Like, that's disgusting.
Me? No.
COVID?
COVID, yeah, no, bro. Not only, yeah, disgusting, but disgusting and very inappropriate at this. I just grabbed her by the throat and said, open your mouth, and I spat on her face shield. Or something. But yeah, what I'm saying is the level of indecency on the internet is getting out of hand. And that's me officially getting old. Because I seen somebody, Adam22, who is, he has got a rap podcast.
Okay.
And he referenced this girl and he said, oh, something about some gawk game, right? As in, gawk, 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 right? Was off the charts, whatever, right? And I clicked on the thing. I was like, I don't know what the fuck he's talking about. Clicked on the thing. I thought it was a rapper. Now, don't throw to the screen here, right? Because it's massively...
Yeah, you can't put this on.
Yeah.
You can't put this
on. So I click this. Your mom is looking after Eddie right in front of me. And this is all I heard. And I was like, oh dear.
So anyway, I mean, I can't see it from here, but is that legit on the video?
Just hold your mouth. There. Let him.
No, this was just the person he was talking about. And I was like, who's that? I thought it was a rapper. And the first video that came up was her just gulping this dick. But anyway, the video that he was talking about was this one. Now these guys, now this video is not getting monetized. I haven't had a monetized video in a long time. I'd be amazed if this one made it to actual YouTube. But so someone's heard wet ass pussy and they've went, we can't let these hoes have, you know, the mantle of, or you can't be at the top of the league in filth. So we've come up with a song called Throat Babies. And I've saved this just for you, Máirín.
Thank you.
Throat babies meaning, you know, you're blasting deep inside the throat of a person. And it's...
You couldn't wait to show me this.
Yeah, but it's a real video with a real song now. But the lyrics are fucking great, man.
Lips on my dick and she swirl on it. She be ready to spit. She eating my dick with passion. It feel like she talking to me. She be telling me shit. Yeah, go ahead and spit on it, yo. Pull out my dick and she lick on.
Go ahead and spit on it, yo.
Yeah, I know she with it. Yeah, I know she want it. Paint her face like a Picasso.
Paint her face like a Picasso. Now, if he'd have said, left her face like a Jackson Pollock. ... Lick my bollocks.
Yeah,
I laughed.
He's missing a rhyme there.
Picasso doesn't paint like that. Learn your art.
Yeah, that doesn't make any sense.
Give it a Jackson Pollock out of my bollocks. I'd have fucking hit the roof if he just said that. Da baby, fuck off. Da retard. Lick on my tip and she said I just swallow. Good.
It's not.
I'm talking about this and it's probably 9 years old. People are like, such a dad move. In your gilet. It's fucking 25 years old. Guys wearing Burberry. It's from 1981.
See it 3 times a week, no nobody know. Well, I dig out and eat soon as I hit the dope. 2 days ago, I got hit at the lows. They know I be on go, I get hit at the stove. Ooh, she a gangster. She don't even care if they look in the car. I can't tell if they know. Girl, get the mangles. Let me get my leg out your way. I got manners, I'ma move your hair out the way. She pull that bitch out when she see me. She suck my dick, she put this song on repeat. She love the top, ooh, and she slap. Put a spit from the dick to her mouth, she a monster. And I might love her, she blow bubbles. And put both hands on the dick and massage. Says a little beast, says a little hoe. I love the way you walk, love the way you talk. Let a young nigga come play your throat. Deep stroke your throat till I make you choke.
Deep stroke your throat till I make you choke? Man. Chef's kiss. Baby,
I'm trying to give him to it's almost like they're describing how you get a COVID test as well.
Scraping the back of your throat. Making you gag.
It's basically, I've just come from having a COVID test again.
Put the Q-tip in the bag. Give it back to the nurse. Thanks, Patricia.
Oh, same.
Just those guys, you know, there's a guy in a studio somewhere being like, so that he's got an opening. He's like, just give you a quick rundown of the premise of the song, really. It's just in-depth descriptions of how we like to get our dick sucked. culminating in the verse, throat babies.
I know, it just sounds like...
Throat babies!
That was beautiful, Cole.
Throat babies! That's the way it goes.
Yeah, did they sit down and write this?
Do you think that guy knows what that is? It's a magnifying glass, but I don't know what he's doing with it.
Well, he's put it right up to his eye, which is the opposite of how that works.
Throat babies! Bro.
What?
Let me see. Have we run out of internet now? It's froze. Good. Did it freeze? Oh, froze baby.
Good, I'm glad. That's enough of that.
You know what's going to play out?
I feel like I know how the rest of the song's going to go. You know that sort of way?
Yeah. Oh, it's disconnected. Did it disconnect?
Oh, it's now. Video as well?
No. Man, sacked.net. Throat babies. I be like, kiss on it while we in public to show that you miss it. Kiss on it in public to show that you missed it.
No, don't do that.
Yeah, hey, we're on Castlecourt fucking food court here. Haven't seen you in a while.
There is always two weirdos who are like kissing each overly other's dicks. Sexual in somewhere weird, like Castlecourt food court. Then you're going,
well, that's, you know, when you're like in school or something, and you don't get to see someone that often. You're like, I'll get the bus into town Saturday, finger you outside of fucking KFC. KFC!
This sounds like you're telling a real story. KFC?
I'm telling a real story. Yeah, I fucking wish I was getting fingered at a KFC. You know? Finger licking good. Lick my box mail. Got loads of them. Zinger. Throat baby. Now this is the girl. This is the best bit of the whole video. Oh, so this is the girl that was in the video a second ago.
Oh, okay, porn star.
Gawking it.
Is she actually a porn star? Porn.
Seemingly.
Woman.
Porn performer.
Porn performer.
Adult performer. Yeah, yeah. Hey, don't talk, man. You can get She's getting an ultrasound on her throat, bro.
What?
Ultrasound on the throat to be like, throat baby. You know, antenatal classes.
Do you think people just ran out of ideas?
I love rap videos with like quite obvious product placement as well. They used to do it with Beats a lot. Like, you know, someone would just be doing something and they'd be like,
Motorola flip phone.
Yeah. Or the Jay-Z fucking Pharrell fronting video where he's like, man, look at this cutting edge technology. Canon digital camera. And on the back of it, there was a screen the size of a stamp. And Pharrell's like, subtle flex. You know? Da, da, da. That noise in fronting. Can't not hear it. That's all you hear.
Oh, your mind has went to six other places, Colin.
I've had six other coffees.
Come back in the room.
Throw baby! Oh, he squirted all over her nips. Now, this is symbolic. He's saying... Trying to give you throw babies, trying to bust all on you. And what he means is...
Yeah, what does he mean?
What he means, Maureen, is... It's a sexual act.
Oh. Is that what he's talking about?
And he wants to distribute the semen all over the person. And it's represented in this by him dressed as a fireman with a hose squirting on a woman.
Good to have a job, though.
This podcast won't make it to YouTube, sort of. No. Throw baby! You want to see, you know, like a fucking woman in Saudi Arabia get her arms cut off for, like, having eyes? You can see it on YouTube. You want to see a fucking Saudi Arabian woman get hung from a football net?
Have you seen this?
Yeah.
What? I'm going to take the internet off you.
Who do you think you are, William Gates? I'm going to take the internet off you. Yeah. Very Orwellian. You know. Whatever.
This is trash.
That's
the internet is trash now, isn't it?
I know there's 10 sketches about what people said about Orwellian, but I'm just using it as instead of saying Orwellian.
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 I mean, really? Like, is this what people make now? Like,
throw babies. Yeah.
How much more literal can they make songs like that now? Not much more literal. Yeah, can
there's.
They?
There's no...
Like, songs used to be kind of a bit mystical.
Yeah,
and, like, beautiful, like, lyrics. And, you know, you could have saw it and it was almost like poetry.
You know,
Yeah, they were describing love and
you could tell someone like, you'd be like, this is actually quite a sexy song. You're like, really? I thought it was about something else.
Yeah, or like everyone can interpret it their own way kind of music. Yeah.
And this guy's like, I want to squirt all my cum in your face. And you're like, what does it mean?
Do you know what I mean? Put on like, you know, listen to that and then listen to like, I don't know, anything. Even put on like a Fleetwood Mac song.
Yeah, and it's all about cumming and squirting.
But do you know what I mean? Like, listen to the lyrics.
When they're talking about the chain, they mean human centipede.
I know.
You know?
Yeah.
What's the one with the guy with the cranberry juice? What's that song called?
Dreams? No. What would you call that song? Yeah, Dreams, isn't it?
Yeah. The original title, Wet Dreams.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
So literal. Pull on my veiny dick out of my jeans. Zip down the jeans and squirt on my dick. Come like... on my piss hole. Loads of the cum. Come on your teeth. So much. Like, video? Brilliant. Video's brilliant. Video's a bit... There's more art in the video than there is...
in anything else to
there's
do
more
with
art
it.
In this girl just gawking this cock. Gawk.
I don't like the fact it's just gawk.
That's... I know. But that's her whole job. You know what I mean? She's like, if you're gonna... go hard or go home. You know, she's like, I'm the best at this. The very, very best.
Bet she's not.
At slurping D.
I mean, do whatever you want. Like, obviously, but like, really? That's what you want to be known as? Weird.
She's in music videos, man.
Well, I'm not in a music video. I suppose she's doing well, like, but...
Up that gawk game.
Nah.
Throw baby, do you still buy into the Super Bowl hype? We're starting the questions here. Shout out to all the people on Patreon. Shout out to Patreon, man. It's class. We're doing podcasts over there.
Nice guys over there.
These are great guys.
Guys, plural. I'm done.
You know, it's. I feel very fortunate during a lockdown to be able to buy Lamborghinis. No, not really. But, you know, just to be able to work away. You know, just crack it on. You know, the fans are paying for it, paying for the product.
As I said, I certainly haven't worked in a long time.
When you're telling me.
I know. Could have got a part-time job in hospital, couldn't I?
Doing what?
I don't know.
Eating cereal bars?
Yeah.
Jokes. No, but yeah, get over on the Patreon. There's numerous fucking episodes to listen to. We'll put another one up this Thursday.
Is this a public one?
Yeah. This is a public one, yeah. Going out.
Also, you never talk about this, but genuinely, I get messages from people asking like about this hat and everything. They all get sold on Patreon before they get published. So I was like, Colin, you don't ever post anything
if
like
I get
merch.
I'll put it up
on
Patreon.
It's all gone
on
Patreon. Like, no one sees it.
And then you shout at me, you go, you're not showing off about this as much.
No, I'm just saying, you're not even saying that it's sold.
And you're like, you got to tell sold people out. That they're selling out. And
I'm because people then ask, think that you're not selling them anymore. I'm like, you can't get them in.
Yeah.
They're gone.
Yeah, like the Milkers t-shirts. We sold hundreds of them on fucking
They were gone before you could sell anyone.
Sorry.
I know.
You know?
But that's all I'm saying. So yeah, genuinely, Patreon actually is fun. It's actually...
Yeah, you get early access to the merch. There's specials up there. We did a vlog cast. We should get another date now to film a second one of those. The aim is to do one a month, one vlog cast a month. And we'll let it go for about 2-3 months and then we'll put a wee trailer together and be like, where do you want to see us go, guys? Where should we go? What should we do? Obviously, lockdown fucks everybody. You can't be out socializing with people doing stuff during a lockdown, even if it is safe. It's just not, everyone else can't do it. So why should I be doing it? You know what I mean? But get yourself on the Patreon. And there was a few problems with the Patreon where people were like, Why has nothing been updated since 2020 in November? And I was like, oh, it has. Quite literally dozens of podcasts since then. And I think what happens is sometimes if you like delete the app or there isn't a payment taken or something weird, it just cancels it on you. And people are still going into the app going, this isn't updated.
Oh, but they're not actually...
But it'll be updated since the last time that it took...
It's like unjoined them sort of thing?
Yeah, like it took a payment off you. You'll get up to that point, basically.
Oh, right.
So people need to check their app and everything can be played through the app if you follow me on Patreon.
Log back in. That's
so log back in, see what the last thing I posted is obviously a request for questions, but it'll be this podcast and then a podcast on Thursday. So I just want everyone to confirm with me that you're up to date. Good lads. And we'll get another, our next, what do you call it? Vlogcast is going to be me and Shane, I think, hiking, which is outside, you know what I mean? We'll stay away from each other, try and make them not kiss me in the mouth again. Question one. Do you buy into the Super Bowl hype? Oh, wait, we should do all our sponsor while we're here, shouldn't we? FlowCBDLTD.com. Do you have the box? Where's the box?
It's over there.
Man.
Do we need the box?
For the first week ever, we are going fucking public with the 10% discount for FlowCBDLTD.com. The code is...
do you want the box?
BanterFlow. Yeah, show them the box. Throw it over there now. It's BanterFlow is your discount code. If you follow the link in the video or in the fucking podcast or whatever, chuck it over. Oh. There we are. Camera shy. Flow CBD. They're doing this box, which is like a, what's the term for
it's
it?
Like, your face.
Like a gift box or something.
Yeah, it has, it's like a whole event in a box. It's lovely.
Yeah, there's fucking CBD. There's a CBD bath bomb. There's fucking
there
candles.
Is a bath bomb
there's
in
a
it.
Playlist. There's a small vibrator. It's all in there. Just, you know, and Valentine's Day is coming up. And yeah, these are like a sample run of them. So get on it before they're sold out. It's a fucking some serious product, sir.
Should I open it now?
Go for it.
I can open it.
That's good for the audio. Jesus Christ, tonight.
Sorry.
So yeah, flowcbdltd.com, use the code BANTERFLOW. It's live till the 15th, so the day after. Is that a scarf?
Yeah, there's everything. There's cozy. It's not a sock, there's cozy.
Socks!
Yeah, there's everything. Oh my goodness, it smells amazing. And a gorgeous candle as well.
Gorgeous candle, bag of grass.
It's basically, like, I'm not going to show it all off because I want it to be a secret, but it's, yeah, it's like a full little...
It's a full care package.
Care package for people.
It's all about chilling and feeling
good. It would
good,
actually
man.
Be a really nice Valentine's present.
Yeah. Great stuff. But
it smells so good.
We were kind of doing an exclusive to the Patreon discount code, but it's live now till the 15th. It's now the 9th. So if you use code BANTERFLOW... all caps, you get 10% off all your purchases. So you might as well load up, you know what I mean? Stay chilled out. I'm full of CBD gummies and it's made me relaxed as fuck.
You just put it right in your coffee, don't you? Mix it up.
Yeah. Throw babies! Right, let's get into some questions, will we? Darkness. Jack Black has always been a bit strange, but do you think he's lost his mind with this latest video? What was that video?
Is that the one from today?
What was it?
I didn't actually get washing properly. It was in thing, but... Is that playing on outside?
Yeah, it's playing on the speaker. I'll play it over here. For fuck's sake, man. Don't go over to the screen just yet. I'm logging into my Instagram. And you wouldn't want to see what's in there, let me tell you. My name is Jack fucking Black.
What's your Instagram password? Colin is cool. One.
It's not that complex.
What was? Did anyone have any good fun email addresses for MSN? What was yours? Did you have any cool ones?
No.
You know, everyone had embarrassing emails.
No, mine was Gedzilla, like 84 for a long time, and my birthday is 86. So I don't know why I didn't just put 86. Retarde.
What was your password? Skateboy. Was it not so really,
no, this is fucking really embarrassing. Honestly, it was like, I forget what exactly it was, but it was literally something like cool guy, like, you know, the default password that they give you? It was like cool guy, fucking 823 was the first, you know, you first get a Hotmail.
Like, yeah.
And they were like, this is your default one, change it. You can change it now or whatever. And I just changed it to like cool guy 123 or something. I just changed it by a couple of digits. I was like, that suits. They must have knew I was lying, to be honest.
They obviously apply these personally.
Now, where's that noise going? Man, we're having major issues with the Bluetooth today. I'd like to complain to our provider that it's wank. And then, what was the question? Did you have an embarrassing one?
Yeah.
What was
embarrassing
it?
Hotmail. And it was, again, it was...
Maureen loves boys.
Yeah, no, it's worse than that. It's so
Throat Baby's 19?
No.
What was it? SpongeBob 12?
It was someone much older than me made it for me. Because you know when you're like, you didn't even know how that worked? Like, someone's like, do you have MSN? And you're like, I don't know what that means.
41-year-old when she was 17?
No, but I was just the oldest in my family. And like, this is before broadband, like, remember? So, which you didn't know.
Where you live is fucking, was like 2018.
Yeah, we only recently got broadband, basically. And I had no idea. And then this girl was like older than me, I was like, I'll make it. She was like an older sister of someone, and she's like, I'll make you one. She's like, I was gonna use this one, but you can have it. And I was like, right, okay. And I was like, yeah, just whatever. And it was two, I think it was actually the number two and then like underscore good, and I'm pretty sure good was spelled G-U-D.
yeah,
for you, too good for you at hotmail.com. like, what? Too good for who?
Yeah,
just for you. Too good for, yeah, you. As of whatever.
Give us this water.
12-year-old, probably. Yeah. He's never, like...
Yeah. You wish, mister.
Never kissed someone. Too good for you, though.
Yeah. You wish. In your dreams.
But, like,
nonce, boy.
Imagine.
Yeah.
Too good for you, so...
Nochecksallowed.com.
Like, embarrassing.
Let's watch Jack White.
No sound call.
Have I lost it again? Scrap. I don't think Mickey has the budget for that. Yeah, but that's quite a funny video. But yeah, he's obviously like, nothing in my career worked as well as the naked pants. Ridiculous. You know? And then he's just like,
I like him.
Everything I do now is in my pants. Ridiculous.
Colin, I feel like... He comes across as a guy a bit like you, who's just too warm all the time. I think that'll be you in your 50s.
Yeah.
Like the guy from Friday Night Dinner.
The term is fat.
Roasting. Yeah. Well, there you go. Yeah, you just
I don't think so. He's not wearing a gilet, is he?
But you're not wearing any trousers, so.
I am. But they're frontless chaps.
No
the
knickers.
Trouser down the back. No trouser at the front. If I'm too warm.
A blanket then. Sitting on a blanket.
If I'm too warm, the number one giveaway is my shins are roasting. She get really warm shins.
That is makes no sense.
Ring da ga 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 ding da ga 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 ding da ga ga ga.
Stop it.
Seeing that you're into your pedos, if you had to have sex with two people with a combined age of 30, what age would the two people be? Thanks, bro.
Jesus.
This
Christ.
Is the same guy that asked if when were we releasing a porno.
But really, what he really wanted to ask was that question.
Yeah, I feel sick. Seeing that you're into your pedos.
Are you into pedos?
No, I mentioned that I was fascinated by a, I nearly said Jimi Hendrix, Jimmy Savile documentary that I watched one time.
Yeah, but that's because he's a psychopath.
Yeah,
correct. Same way you're into people.
What age would they be? Probably definitely both 15. And both the guys would be very mature 15-year-old boys. I'm joking. We'll skip the fight talk. Sorry. Really glad to hear your wife is doing well in Liz's podcast. Keep up the awesome work, man. Thank you.
Me or you?
Me. Okay. Just want to say that you and your beautiful wife... Guys, nothing
See,
stopping
you. See, I told you,
you
makeup looked really good last time.
Calling me beautiful either.
I look rough today. You look much more beautiful than me today.
Consistently shite. Let me tell you something. There's no ups and downs with me.
No, that's true.
The graph of attractiveness,
yeah,
sits at a 4.
So everyone will look like trash when they're like 60, but you look like that.
Yeah.
So,
honestly, the joke in the Iron Fighter documentary was, you know, I'm like, I can't believe it's been 10 years, and then I turn the screen right and I look exactly the same.
You look exactly the same.
You know, some say I would look better now.
Yeah.
Compared to 10 years ago, definitely better shape. Now. Not a lot better shape, but resembling a human shape.
You've lost at least 2 pounds in 10 years.
Oh, that's right.
The slow process.
Just wanted to say you're a beautiful wife for an inspiration. Thanks. The whole cancer thing, especially during the pandemic, could have made a weaker couple fractious. Oh, we hate each other. You guys smashed it, and your wee man is a lucky duck. Bit soppy, but fuck it, we're all thinking of it. And then this emoji.
Oh, we're going to tell him that every day.
You lucky wee... I do that. Sometimes I'll make him a meal, and I'm like, look at this, bro.
I know.
Fucking look at this, you lucky wee shit. And then he like bundles it up and throws it in the floor. And I'm like, that is a croque monsieur.
This is the recent thing he's done, though. Usually he just eats everything, but...
You bastard.
No, he's like this.
Sometimes you are. Like, no. We used to really make some effort when he was, like, weaning. But now I'm just like, no, just give him the dog food and the fucking frozen peas on the side.
No, you don't.
I make no effort at all. You know, you used to have, like, a wee selection of stuff and, you know, have a little...
You're not supposed to tell me that. You're supposed to tell me when I was away, you give him perfectly balanced meals.
No, well, look, I managed to... whittle it right down to
just
bananas
well.
And slow cooked beef, and that was it.
God, he loves bananas, doesn't he?
Nah.
Literally loses his mind. I posted this for the podcast with Maureen, but realized it probably wasn't the most appropriate topic, so here goes again. Could you fucks with squeak rap? Skip to 25 seconds when your mom walks out.
I quite appreciate that someone just thought it wasn't appropriate. That's quite sweet.
Sorry, I'm having difficulties. Let me see. Is that playing through? I can't win today! Where's that playing through?
Why don't you just turn your speakers off so stuff's connecting them now? Too simple?
Don't you, Maureen. Throw babies! I'll work it out. Just give me 12 or 10 minutes.
What is this?
Squeak rap?
Oh, this is music?
Let me see now. Of course. What the fuck is all this shit? Trippy Red. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, wait. What's the guy's name? That's the actual guy's name. I mean,
this is where other people probably load these things up in advance.
Well, I didn't know. Yeah. Squeak rap. Squeak rap? Is this squeak rap? Is this for real?
Now this I could get into.
Yo, what's up, man? I've got the really catchy rap name of 645AR.
Is he really doing that? No, that can't be real. That'd be like stuff they put on to like torture people.
I am speechless.
Shout out FK Twin. What? What has happened to music?
There's me. Hold on. There's a guy. That is gonna get the 14-year-olds on TikTok shaking their bee stings right in the camera.
Oh my god.
Nonce world! Does he go backstage and just barf blood into a sink? After 10 minutes of that shit?
That's like the opposite of like screamo metal, isn't it?
Mouse rap?
It's fucking squeaky rap.
What the fuck is that?
I mean, it's got a bit of like De Antwoord vibes too, like to be fair, but... They call you go from De Antwoord.
Yeah, but at least somehow she gets her anus out.
That does make it sound better.
My actual voice is quite cool. I can't do it. It hurts me. You were talking about skullets recently. Look up Devon Townsend skullet. Nothing more ugly but mesmerizing at the same time. Who's that?
He's a metal guy.
Is he?
Yeah. Prog.
I thought you said broad.
Progestant.
Skullet, I think you should grow your hair out, Colin. To see.
I've seen this guy live.
Have you?
Yeah, he's pretty extreme.
He's just a bald guy.
Oh no, that's the... You need the earlier one. Young.
Just Google him.
Oh no.
Oh yeah, boy. We're not supposed to play gigs like this when we're bad boys. This is Welcome to the Music Podcast.
I know, yeah.
He's got fucking... Has he got dreads in there too?
Oh my god.
When you absolutely 100% want to have women look at you ever. Be a baldy white dude with him.
He looks a wee bit like your woman from Married to First Sight. This podcast being cancelled now, isn't it?
This is
Jesus Christ.
This is what I say when someone's like, "Lad, is the video not ready for the podcast yet?" And then I'm like, hold on a second. So ladies and gentlemen, stick this in your fucking
cunt. Jesus Christ.
Is that downloading? Did he just say cunt? Stick in your cunt. What's the band called? Terrible name. The most embarrassing bit of that was when he goes, "Stick it in your fucking cunt!" And then no one responds. And then, you know, like, he's waiting for everyone to go, "Yeah!" And he goes, "Stick it in your cunt!"
1, 2, 3.
So stick it up your fucking cunt! Can the podcast... can it be called singing
your
fucking
gun? No, okay. It can't.
We move
it
on.
It can't.
We move on. Listen, you don't shoot, you don't score. Round here. What songs do you most like to play on guitar? And if there's any, what ones are you learning at the moment? Bro, what are you talking about? I just pick it up and thrash about. I'll make a fucking...
Do you shout like that down the room? Yeah.
I go, "Stop it up your fucking cunt!" And then I go...
Time of your life. Green day.
Ding, ding, ding. Yeah. Or do a Mickey, you know. It's hard to control your mouth, your concentration mouth. You know, Mickey will put on his camera and be like, ding, ding, ding. Mm-hmm. It's nice. He's like a shot. Ding, 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 ding. What song would I like to learn? I don't know. I would just love to be able to do just a bunch of sweet sort of blues licks, you know? Not even a whole song. You know where you like go into a guitar shop and you go, "Let's get a look at that." You just like big, you know what I mean?
Do you see the video and it was some girl playing loads of riffs being like, what do you call the one Nelly Guitar Store does? Is it called that?
Mm-hmm.
She's like, "Here's what all employees are sick of hearing. These are 8 riffs." And it was like, it was so funny. Like, you can just imagine everyone goes in being like, "Look at me."
Yeah.
I wonder if anyone watching me.
No Stairway. What songs were they?
I don't know. There was like loads of them. Really
ACDC?
Yeah.
Smoke on the Water. So what funny. Else is there?
You could.
Seven Nation Army out of, in the wrong tuning. what else?
Yeah. What else did you say? Smoke in the water.
Like fucking smells like Teen Spirit.
Yeah. Yeah. Always.
Where is my mind? Yeah. Ah, your mate in the background. What about what about the end of the Chappelle special where they play Where's My Mind on the piano? Bro, I was like, man, such tasteful choices, David. Tasteful. You know when he plays DNA at the end of, bro, ruined it for everyone. Like if you ever thought DNA was a good song and you're like, man, I've got a big gig coming out, let me walk out to DNA. You're like, no, who do you think you are, Dave Chappelle, you stupid fat wanker? And I'm like, yeah, I bought the jumpsuit and everything.
Ducking yourself in.
You'll sit there. You'll bloody sit there till I get it back in. I'm not looking. Wireless. Wireless my ass. My throat babies. Colin, did you hear about the Jerusalem Magarda dance challenge? No, I can't click. Well, I'll click it. All right, I'll click it. Let me see. Jerusalem. What is that?
Is it not just a dance or something?
What's Jerusalem?
I don't know.
Yeah, it's a bunch of guards dancing. Guys, fucking fight some crimes, you know what I mean? How about a breakdown of this? I'm about to fucking have a breakdown. Oh yeah, this is good. Right, pause for 3 or 4 more minutes to attack this out. Devin time to shove this in your cunt! 1980s Irish Catholic sex education. Oh, 1980s. Jesus. Stick your fucking... No. Oh. Irish Catholic. Which is, it's very important that you write Irish Catholic.
Yeah.
You can't just write Catholic.
No, it's a different breed altogether.
Sex education video. Here she is.
Yours.
Taking the back end off her. Brush your hair. Let's not get sexual, because she's 12. Ireland hasn't changed at all, has it?
I mean, all these clothes are quite cool now.
Yeah. Zoom in on a heart. Nice. Sex education for girls. Don't be having it.
For girls, exactly, which means they're not going to tell you anything.
Yeah.
Hello, I'm Angela.
Simply put a piece of sellotape over your entrance.
And over the next few sessions, we're going to be together talking about you growing up.
I'm hard already.
What?
Its changes. And a lot more. And I think you're going to find it fascinating.
Creepy doll bend?
Everything is based on love. And the person who loves us most of all is God. So, let's start by asking him to help us to understand about it all. Dear Lord, I want to invite you to be with us as we talk together about growing up. Because you are the inventor of people. You are the one best able to understand us and help us to understand and love one another.
Hey, translations.
Sexual intercourse in the only the vagina. From the front exclusively.
So, this is the newlywed couple here, and they're showing their love for each other by lovemaking. Lovemaking just means making each other feel loved. How do you make a person feel loved? Well, you give them kisses and hugs. Oh, no.
By ripping half her head off.
What's happening to her face?
Hold them close. But between a man and a woman, it's a bit different. Because when they hold each other really close and give a long kiss and a warm hug, they tell each other that they're beautiful and everything like that. And they also have a bit of a laugh because they are the best of friends. And then something happens.
He takes the back end off her.
In a very short time, because they're so...
There'll be things called throat babies.
I know, cut to this, the other song.
Cut the fucking throat baby!
The man feels his penis becoming erect. That's straight.
Is right, bro!
and the sperm coming down into it, like it did when he had a wet dream. Now, while the sperm is coming into the man's penis, the woman's body is getting ready to receive the sperm. It's amazing, you know, how God made it. Because while they're making love and being happy together, the woman feels her vagina becoming kind of slippery inside, so that the penis can easily slip in and out. No trouble. So he slips his penis into her vagina, gives her the sperm, then she has the sperm. Then the penis slips out, and that's all. And that's called sexual intercourse.
Jesus.
Smell it?
Some people call it having sex.
They do not.
So the man passes the sperm to the woman, and now his sperm... Maybe you're wondering if a mistake could be made and a man could pass water instead of semen and sperm when having sexual intercourse.
Bro. Imagine. I don't know if you're pregnant or not because I actually let out a full pish in the mirror. Does it cancel it out if I do my semens and then a full 90 second pish because I've had quite a few pints? Just pish it, just gushing out everywhere.
Thank God that doesn't happen. Because for sure guys would do that.
It's kind of impossible. Do you ever piss with a boner?
Not recently.
Try it.
But that can't happen.
Exactly.
Because there's a valve which closes to stop the urine coming when sexual intercourse is taking place. Now, possibly you're saying to yourself, oh, I'll never do that. It's awful.
You fucking will, you dirty cunt.
You hear about it first. It sounds very strange. But God has made it really lovely. An exciting and pleasant feeling.
Oh! No way that bit. That, someone's cut that in at the end.
They have to. That's actually a lot more like detailed than I thought.
Yeah.
Not gonna lie.
It's as detailed as throat babies. You know? And when he's ready to deliver the semen, he will pull out and glaze the buns like an old fucking cinnamon roll. And you'll wait there till he runs around to the hot press to find some sort of cloth. And then you'll roll over and you'll watch Big Bang Theory. And you'll put it back to resume the episode.
No.
Someone had to cut that in at the end. Like, she's like, I'll not say it as graphically, but at the end, subtle hint. God has made it exciting. What a chat up line. Do you fancy the ride? No. God has made it exciting.
I know they do that because obviously in Catholic schools, everything is brought back to Jesus being involved. But it's a lot creepier when they describe it like that, isn't it? He'll be watching and he wants this to happen to you.
God's just fucking cocking hand, like, make it slippery. I don't like the way she was saying when the sperm comes down your penis.
No. That's a bit, no, why?
Squirts out it. Doesn't go down it.
What?
Have you seen Greenland with Jared Butler? Fairly intense watch. Question in relation, if an apocalypse type disaster was hit to hit Earth, would you be one of the mad bastards who would try to survive it at all costs, murdering, stealing, kidnapping, rioting, or would you just accept and live your last few days of doing nothing as the inevitable was going to happen anyway?
Jesus, that's a big question, huh?
I don't know. There's something quite... I remember at the start of the lockdown thing, there was... I actually genuinely felt a little bit of excitement. I was like, oh, fuck, imagine... You know what I mean? You're like, ooh, this is weird. Imagine you did actually have to like fend for yourself a wee bit.
Yeah, you quite like the idea of like building a big fence with like barbed wire and CCTV everywhere and like crazy dogs and freezers full of food.
Sort of. Yeah. I might thrive in a world like that. In a world where you survive by hitting people in like zombies in the head with an axe, I might do well. Might suit that world better.
Yeah.
Is that your noise?
Sorry, I don't know.
Do you need more blood now?
I guess it's been made. It's a noise it makes.
Hey, let's watch that tonight. I need something exciting to watch. Greenland. No, almost as a hobby, I think I could get into doomsday prepping. I wouldn't actually be a crazy person being like, you know, you got when your neighbors try and steal your petrol, but it's fun to be like, mm-hmm. you know, we got a room here that you can get in and you can climb out the roof and there's a fucking turret gun. You know, it excites me a wee bit. Like I got spare fuel in there. You know, I've got petrol burner. You're gonna be able to get petrol easier than.
Do you mean? I think you're just.
By the way, your dad a petrol burner, which was like a lamp, and he's like, mm. it's because you can get petrol. Petrol's the handiest thing to get, not diesel or like any other fuel. So this is a lamp that you can like cook on or just use it as a light. And he lit it on your kitchen table and nearly killed all of us. Some man.
Sounds about right.
Let's watch that tonight. I work in retail. Oh, fuck my eyes. I work in retail and it's rough at the minute. I was watching an older podcast you did with Maureen and you were talking about working in Currys. Any more tales from back then? No, not really. I mean, it was just fucking... It was a sitcom, you know what I mean? You just had an alcoholic manager, one black guy, you know, couple of hot chicks.
Who were you then?
I was the Tim. Like, if you watch The Office, I was the fucking normal guy who just would look at the camera and go... all the time. That
it
was
still
me.
Makes me laugh thinking of you working.
I know. In a shop.
But I get a shop.
Job.
Put
we
a
come in here at
on.
9:30 and only start recording at 2:00. Hard work.
I mean, imagine you doing that.
Now, Maureen, clocking I don't know if you believe this or not. I didn't take it very seriously.
I do. I know.
They brought me in at Christmas to try and scare me a bit and go like, we're reviewing your figures here. And I went, I'll just leave. And the guy went, what? And I was like, I'm leaving. And he's like, what do you mean? And I was like, I don't want to talk about this.
Yeah, this is already too much.
There's only so many lies I can tell about fridges. Let me go home. It's trash. What sort of funny things happen? Don't know. There was definitely a guy like learning diffs and his ma brought his laptop in and the battery had just come out. Remember when the battery used to just clip in the back of the laptop? Was not in right. They fired it up. It was full of porn.
Oh, really?
Oh,
dear.
This, what are their wild tales?
Retail is one of the toughest jobs. I know that's like a broad statement, but like.
I know.
Not physical. Like, do you know what I mean? It's not like the physical.
It's
like
draining trying to talk shit to people. Like yeah. sales type things.
It's a hard one in so many ways.
I had the lowest rate of returns though, because I just didn't bullshit people.
Good boy.
I was just like, let me tell you something. LG make all the screens, buy whatever fucking one you want. I don't give a fuck. Back when I worked there, when I was like, guys, keep this to yourselves, but we were one of the first guys in Northern Ireland to get our hands on a 1 gigabyte card. SD card. Much is it? $899. But for you, $850. $850 quid.
I know.
Man, hundreds of photos you're talking. Hundreds of photos.
30 songs.
Yeah, you can get every single fucking Weedus album on this. Of which there are probably none. What's the venue you're most looking forward to getting back to?
The pub.
The pub. Oh, clip it. for comedy, definitely Lavery's. Definitely go back to Scotland. I love going to Scotland. Galway, you know, I like going to Galway.
You kind of only go to places you like.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. You know, we were talking about Dublin, and I was like, the last time I was in Dublin, like, there was like fucking 200 and, I think it was like 260 people. I was like, Whelan's was full of people. Whelan's, like, an established
big venue.
Good venue. Like, would be a big venue for, like, anyone coming up in Dublin. And I was like, the place was packed. And I was just in a hurry to get home because you were pregnant or some bullshit.
Mm.
You know?
I know. I think you deserve to do a tour without serious mental pressure.
Yeah.
If it was to...
Yeah. I yes. mean, yeah. 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 Be great to just be like, we have a healthy baby, I have a healthy wife, no pressure to rush home because she has another baby real quick. You know, just chilling out, man.
Just enjoy yourself, man.
The tours will get a lot longer. I'll be like, I have a gig in Liverpool. and you'll be like, oh, cool, so what time are you back tomorrow? And I'll be like, hey, I'll be back in 2 weeks.
Yeah. I know. No, we're coming with you everywhere.
Yeah. Whatever. What's your favourite and least What's your favorite and least favorite thing about this country? Oh, I mean, fuck me.
Sometimes they're the same thing.
Wow.
You know what I mean? What the people, mean? But also the people.
Yeah.
You know?
The people, but the fuck me, the people.
Yeah. The bars, but also the bars.
Yeah. You know, it's like, the bars, but also stay open.
Yeah. The weather, but the weather.
It's a very, you know, compared to what this country has had in its past, it's a very tame place to live. You know, it's reasonably priced. The weather's kind of shite, but it's not extreme. You know, there's no like heat waves and typhoons or, you know.
Yeah, like Frank was showing us pictures of like
the Netherlands. It was snowing like,
it's like minus ridiculous.
Everything's pretty fucking like, it's okay across the board. Everything's fine. You know what I mean?
I think we're just a bit behind here.
Yeah, I think, you know, like
in all sorts of things.
At the minute I'm like, Jesus Christ, every cunt's got a podcast, but like everyone should have had a podcast 7 years ago.
Yeah.
But it's just catching up with itself now. Yeah. It's like, it's so behind. And like trying to sell, you know, ads to people for podcasts and stuff just seemed like insane 2 years ago. People are like, no.
Yeah.
Let me put an ad in the paper for 9 people to see it. Please. But yeah, when the sun comes out here, you know, you'd be in certain places and you're like, you wouldn't want to be anywhere else. This is lovely.
Yeah.
But, you know, when you wake up and it's dark and then it's shite quality of light for like 1 hour before it gets dark again, you're like, I would live in Dubai in a slum instead of this shit. Take my passport, cut my hands off, I don't care. I'll work up scaffolding 9 miles in the air.
No, you wouldn't. You'd never get
it. No, I would hate that. Just let me stay here. Let me see. Did you see BBC Panorama about boxing and the Kinahan cartel? Crazy. Write that down.
Panorama. Is that the one we were going to watch?
I want to say, I watched fucking clip upon clip upon montage of stuff about like crime in Dublin and stuff and the Kinahans and fucking all this shit and boxing and all that carry on. And you read it and you're like, this happened down the road. Like, it sounds like something you'd hear, you know, you'd see in a movie about like mafia in fucking Chicago or something. And you're like, nope, this is happening just down south. Boys are fucking murdering the shit out of each other.
But let's watch it.
Yeah, oh well.
Report back.
Report back. Of course, this is frozen. Cool. Right, well, what time is it? Right, we've been talking for way too long. Well, what's your take on the Jackie Weaver shite? What's that?
It was like a parish Zoom call.
Oh. I don't give a fuck about that. They were. It wasn't even that bad, was it? They were just like rying over some... Ah, fucking, he gives a flying fuck.
You can't. That's far down the line after those music videos. After Throat Babies. Yeah, it's not.
It can't start with Throat Babies.
No,
and
you
with
can't.
A fucking war in a parish fucking.
Yeah, no. We started the wrong way, right?
Throat Babies! No, you're a fan of Rory Gallagher. No, you're a Rory Gallagher fan. What's your favourite Rory album? And have you ever been down to his tribute festival in Ballyshannon? No, I haven't because he's not there.
I know. We've said for about 10 years we're going to go and we've never managed to go.
And then someone tells me stories like, oh, it was class. We put a tent up in someone's front garden instead. And I was like, no.
Yeah.
No.
And it's freezing.
No. Find me the closest hotel spa and I will meander down the street to the festival at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Thanks.
It's when you realise you're essentially just going to Bendorn at a time when it's not good weather. You're like, no.
You drank enough. You want.
We can have our own one just in our own house.
What's my favourite album? Obviously, the fucking live Irish tour one. Or Go Fuck Yourself.
Is that his other one?
Yeah.
That one.
Welcome to the stage.
Fucking cunt.
Boy. Yeah.
This is two albums.
Stab this in your... Shove this in your fucking cunt. Ding, 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 ding. So I've basically a jumper that I can't take off. What's your take on being a big hairy cunt? Shave the shoulders and back or go feral? Shameless Manscaped plug. No, I don't have a jumper that I can't take off. I'm not hairy like that. Like one of those guys where it goes fucking thick over your shoulder and you have to like cut.
Does he not mean like it looks like you have a jumper on?
Yeah. I don't look like that.
Oh, right, yeah.
I look like I've got a waistcoat on of of pig hair. Doesn't everyone?
Yeah, yours is more just like a hairy belly.
Yeah.
And then just the back. looks like you've got a bad tattoo of angel wings. It's not even evenly placed hair, which is the problem.
Man,
I actually wouldn't mind if it was fully hair.
Oh, really?
It's more just like...
Because there was a guy onto me from that micro fucking dot thing where they draw hair under your follicles.
No, you've enough.
No, I've got that Gorilla Blade thing, which is a godsend.
Yeah.
And then your only real obstacle is the fact that my back is about, about 2 meters wide.
Usually I'm shaving it and you're like, this is a chore.
Yeah.
Because of how wide you are. But now I've got
this other thing and I'm just like, shht. And it works like fuck, too.
But I've noticed over the years, it started to creep over your hair like a big scary spider, just creeping over your shoulders.
Yeah.
So it definitely's turned into a waistcoat, like.
Now you're a hairy guy on the tits and belly? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What about any trouble with the back? Or are you like, you're like, that's not my jurisdiction? Can't see it. Who gives a fuck? A few strays. It's called being a man, Maureen.
I think it's all right being hairy. I don't think... Some people are like, ugh, hair. And you're like, I think it's sometimes weirder looking or really like shiny looking.
Oh, yeah. Like my dad is like a fucking bar of soap.
I don't... And it's gross. But I think because I'm so used to looking at you now, the idea of a man without chest hair is actually weird looking to me.
It is super weird.
It actually creeps me out.
Yeah.
It's still... My funniest thing about your chest hair, though, is on our honeymoon, whenever... It makes me laugh so much, this. So Colin had never, ever shaved... your chest hair, anything, ever. And it's so dark, like, such dark hair. And you're like, I might trim it.
Yeah.
So Colin trimmed it.
I waited until I was on honeymoon before I did it as well.
You never thought to ever just be like, I'll do any sort of grooming at all before any of these things. Great. But you decided to trim it. So, I mean, you took off half a millimeter, I think, of hair.
No, it was a good inch.
And you're like, yeah, well, okay, it was an inch. And it was still full hairy chest, like fully, like, so hairy, like an animal. And we were both like, oh my god, what have you done? Like, it was such a difference that we just couldn't believe it.
It was at least like a centimeter of hair that looked like chest.
It just looked like regular hairy chest.
Just because it wasn't the Austin Powers like floating up in the hot tub hair, I was like, I'm bald.
We were just like, oh my god, Colin, what have you done?
I know.
And you look back at photos now being like, It's hairier than it's ever been now that we look at it.
Yeah.
Because now you fully almost shave your chest.
Like, you know there was like some fucking Mexican cleaner in the room. You're just going, oh my goodness, they have a pet dog in here or something? They wash a collie in the hot tub? Everywhere.
Well, we couldn't believe it. Oh my God, your chest hair, literally, you could have brushed it.
Yeah. Sexy.
Funny.
As Maureen ever said to you after a podcast, you shouldn't have said that, or you've went too far in particular?
I'm pretty sure I might have, but not really. Maybe like years ago when I was like just afraid maybe you'd offend someone, or maybe you said something bad, but
I'll stand behind everything I say, but it's happened with other people.
Yeah, it's never ever something
where
like
they say something and they go, okay, I might have overshared there, take it out. Mm-hmm. But I don't give a fuck about
it. No, I never say, I don't really ever say it, you know. What would you say? You know, like, I don't know.
I'm sitting on one secret right now, which isn't really a secret. Well, it is, but I'm not allowed to talk about it.
Oh.
And it's burning a hole in my pocket.
Well, you can't keep secrets, that's why.
Who do you want? Secrets are shit, man.
I love them. I love surprises. You can't do it. Cannot do it.
No.
I don't think I've ever had a present before on Christmas Day ever, because you've always given it to me as soon as you bought it.
I give you presents all year round.
I know, but do you know what I mean? Like, normally, people would save Christmas. You can't keep anything secret. No.
I go against the system. I'll give you your fucking...
I know, I like it.
I'll give you your Christmas present in November.
Nice. I think it's nice. But no, I've never stopped you saying anything.
Will you be returning to BJJ post-pandemic? I think I'd like to.
Yeah.
I'd very much like to. That question was for you. Sorry.
For me?
Yeah.
Might take it up.
You should. Have you watched It's a Sin? No, but I'd like to.
It looks good.
Since you were flying Andy Malone private jet, have you been a pilot long, and did you meet him?
Did you look like someone in a video?
Must have. New addition to the desk. What's this? Fuck's sake, here we go. Oh, it's a stress scrotum.
Oh.
It's a little, it goes under the desk and you squeeze the balls. If you had to pick one, would you rather suck dick or take it up the ass? what would you say was gayer?
Wow.
There's gayer things than that.
What's gayer than that?
Just like wearing a cardigan.
Is it?
It's pretty gay. Yeah. Being into baking. It's gay. Yeah, being gay has nothing to do with sexual things.
No.
You know?
Not anymore.
Whatever gets you squirting. Gayness is like, you know, like the music you listen to and stuff, and you're like, not again. You know what I mean? People are over that. Sucking dick's not gay. You know what I mean? Taking it in the butt? No, it's not gay if it feels good. Let your wife peg you in the shitter.
You should be Catholic schoolboy education for you. Yeah.
If you're having trouble putting the peg in the arse, simply spit on it to make it slippery. God is watching.
Don't use an actual peg.
Yeah, not an actual peg.
Clippy.
You will need to have a special phallus crafted at a local sex emporium. Spit on it, make it slippery. Make sure you've cleaned out the shed beforehand, as we say. Or you'll be shunting the cocoa back up.
Yeah.
What?
No.
Pagan. What's in it for me? No thanks.
Yeah, I don't get it. I don't get
what's in it for anyone?
What's in it for anyone? Who wants to peg someone? Nah.
See the video of Tom Segura's injury? When watching fucked up injuries, do you almost fold in half? Yeah, it makes me, especially broken bones. I can watch blood and all day, but like, what's the crack with every podcast in the world being sponsored by Manscaped? Genuinely curious, as everything I watch and listen to has them as a sponsor. I think it's because podcasts are a lot more real and sometimes a lot more edgy than mainstream TV. So,
and because of it's the type of product, isn't
yeah,
it?
it's like Fleshlight, you know.
Yeah, they're not going to advertise.
They did well on podcast promotion.
Also, they probably know it's a bit. That's probably their main.
Yeah,
they're probably there is like their only marketing, so they're not going to be on TV or whatever. There's no point. They're just.
Yeah, it's the demographic that listens to podcasts. It just works better. Oh fuck! Of course, our last question doesn't work. That's cool. It was obviously someone doing an Indian impression, and they were like, "I thought this was you."
Oh God.
Since you've been gone, bastard. Hold on, let me see if I can play it just normally. Oh Jesus Christ, where's oh no sir, is it gonna play? worth it.
That scared me because it's playing on the speaker over there.
If you hate me, you can save me, baby. All my lives I've been good, but now what the hell? Hello bastards, I'm making the aloo gosh traditional authentic style. I show you how to make next video. No need for the base gravy. This is desi style. Very, very simple. So simple you laugh again. Ha ha, too fucking loud.
Anyway, Indian guy making dinners. Did you not say you had a doctor or something when you were younger and he's like, you're experiencing any vomiting?
Yeah. Vomiting.
And the guy was just white from Dungannon?
Yeah. No.
Are you experiencing any vomiting? Anyway, we've talked enough.
Oh, God, I know. I'm not supposed to be here.
I know. Fuck off it. My back drenched with this new gilet. Gilet. Robert Dylan.
Funny, I had a gilet, Colin.
Yeah, I bought Maureen a champion branded silver gilet for Christmas and she looked at it and fucked it aside.
I didn't.
Like it was nothing. And my general vibes were, oh, I don't actually like that. So it lay on the floor in your mum's house collecting dog hair for quite some time. And then I said, it's a shame that that's lying there. And then said to your sister, if you like that, just take it. Because
no,
Maureen fucking despises
you
it.
You bought this. I've been in hospital for a month. And I said, oh, where's that silver gilet?
I must get it. Where is it?
Because I was in hospital for a month.
You didn't give a shit about it.
No, because you were my Secret Santa. So you got me that as Secret Santa.
Worst secrets.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm gonna buy
so
a new one.
So I opened it down at mummy's house.
I'll buy a new one right now.
No, don't. I'll take it. No. Stop it.
Okay.
So I left it down there. Then I went into hospital for a month and then went, oh, I must go down and get that gilet because I saw it in my sister's bedroom. And you went, oh, I give that to Susie. And I was like, you can't give it to her because it was a present. It was my present. You can't give someone's gift away.
I didn't like rewrap it and be like, I got you something.
Yeah.
It was lying on the floor and I went, you may take that if no one's wearing it.
Yeah, because I was in hospital. How could I wear it? So I come back and Colin just gives away gifts.
No, you could quite easily, with no drama, go and take it back. But
I will.
Or are you just holding it above my head for a long time?
Because I feel like this is an actual, like, why would you do that?
Because I'm kind.
You can't go, where's my Gila? And you're like, I just give it to your sister because I thought you didn't want it. How do you know I didn't want it? Your face looked like you didn't want it. That was what you said to me. Your face looked like you didn't want it. When so I asked your sister, did she want
you
it?
You opened it up and you didn't, I don't even think you looked at it. You opened it up without looking at it and just went, a thing I got.
That's not true.
Set it in a pile.
That's not true.
It is.
So you give it to my sister.
Truth bomb.
Here, says, so you just take this. Maureen doesn't want it, even though she's not here to ask. So
no,
I'm right.
No, it was
just, right.
It was lying there, and I said, somebody wear that, please. It was very expensive. Truth bomb.
Well, I didn't get the chance to wear it because I was in hospital. Truth bomb.
Okay. Another truth bomb. We have run out of time today, guys.
There's no such thing, though.
There's no such thing as time.
But if there were, it's done.
Yeah. Thanks to our sponsors again, Manscaped, because they sponsor everyone. Manscaped.com. Use the code GEMBANT1 for 20% off all your products. Valentine's Day is coming up. Bad for your husband or spouse. And be like, shave your bollocks, you fucking mess. And then they've got aftershave as well. And then Flow CBD.
Shave all your bits. Have a nice bath.
Yeah, in that order.
It's the perfect day.
There's a beeswax candle. Light it. Drip it all over your titties for hotness.
No, don't do that.
Yes.
Don't do that.
FlowCBDLTD.com. The discount code is public this week. It's BANTERFLOW, all caps, 10% off all purchases. And of course, get on the Patreon because we're going to set a date for a new vlogcast. We're doing more extra podcasts this week. Yes.
And if and when you record a porn, it'll also be on Patreon.
It'll be on there. Yep. SSE tickets still available. We're also getting a shitload of loads of types of beanie. So, in like about 6 colors.
Like these ones?
Yep. Because people are buying them up. Like, they're selling like hot hats, man.
You can't keep them.
If I order them, they sell, all of them. And I don't show off enough. I should be taking...
Also, to be honest, I don't like hats. I never wear hats. I do wear them now. But this is the only hat I'll wear.
Yeah. Do you remember like Tim and Aaron sold their Dirt Civil hoodies? You know, when they packed up like 6 orders and lay in them like they're fucking O'Day sauce. I'm going to do that with my hats. You know what I mean? Oh, shit.
Oh, your wee gilet's popping everywhere.
I'm sweating. Right, we'll get out of here, Maureen. Cheers for being my guest again, even though you forced me to do it.
No problem.
We'll get Niall a mic for next week since everyone's dying to hear him talk.
I know.
That's all I get. You know, like someone will... be like, when's Niall got his own podcast so I can stop listening to yours, you fuck? There we are. So we will see you Thursday or Friday. Thursday, I think, if you're on the Patreon. So any throat babies in the way home, Maureen, or what?
No.
No? Okay. Mm-mm. Okay.
No.
What about hand babies?
That just sounds so weird.
What about a greased up food, baby? Gross. Right.
Stop talking.
I've got a sore head. Right, just you say we're done.
Right, we're done here.
See
Let's
you later.
Go.
Congas.com for stuff.
Goodbye.